I'm Ellie Setback, reporting.
Can you explain to me something? Demetrius Johnson, Mighty Mouse, insanely talented. You could fit all his fans in a phone booth. How come he's not popular? How come nobody's mentioning his name? How come he's not as popular as Ronda Rousey, McGregor, Nate Diaz? What is the reason? There has to be a reason for that.
Number one, Demetrius doesn't get the push because he's not a Ronda Rousey. He's not a cute blonde white girl. And this is not the black guy pulling the race card. This is just from business. You know what I mean? I'm going to say this. If you look at the women that were pushed in MMA, they're all the absolute opposite of what you think a women's MMA fighter should look like. Gina Carano, beautiful woman, right? Voluptuous, curvy, beautiful face, goes on to movies. Ronda Rousey, same thing. Beautiful face, can speak a little bit, has a little attitude. Women can kind of either relate to her or want to be her, right? Conor
Misha
McGregor.
Tate?
Misha Tate. Can't forget Misha. Love Misha. Cupcake, love her, right? Beautiful
cool.
Body, beautiful face. Men love her.
Nice personality, too.
Great personality.
Humble.
Great fighter. Tries hard, right? But on the opposite side, you got Chris Cyborg.
I think she's badass.
I think Cyborg's one of my favorite fighters
ever.
She's
great boxing.
She ain't doing a Maybelline commercial. You know what I mean? They're not picking at her for her
racist.
Looks.
That's racist. They don't like Brazilians.
I mean, listen, I think the woman's beautiful. I don't like to
she's a
do
very
all
nice
that.
Person.
But it's the business shit that they have to look at.
She doesn't look like a runway model.
She doesn't look like a runway model, right?
So Mighty Mouse is not popular because he's not...
Well, no. Mighty Mouse is in the... He fights at what, 125?
Yes. I always think much less for some reason.
Yeah.
He looks
the weight classes. After, you know, no one really pays attention after 155, 145, and then you got 125. That division doesn't get much love. And it doesn't get... I mean, I don't know.
It's like that in boxing too, but...
Yeah. I mean, the small... I mean, I think it comes in waves, right? Like, for a while, it was all about heavyweights. It was Brock Lesnar and Cain Velasquez and who was the other?
Like Randy Couture
and light heavyweight, Chuck Liddell, John Jones, light heavyweight, all the bigger guys, right?
Anderson Silva.
Shane Carwin, you know, all these big guys that were dropping bombs and dropping people in the knockouts. And then, because I think what happens is the smaller you get, the more technical you have to get. And when you get more technical, you lose the casual fan. You know what I mean? When you really have to look for the nuances of the movement.
Well,
Or the ground game, then
it's funny you say
fall
that.
Off.
Pita Garcia, the son of Robert Garcia, is a very talented trainer. He told me that he says Mighty Mouse is the Rigondeaux of MMA because Rigondeaux is very technical. Rigondeaux is very talented, but he doesn't have the fans supporting him. Like
he doesn't have the casual fans supporting him. He has the diehard fans
supporting
him. He's got the guys who know what he's doing and see what, and respect what he does. But the difference is Mighty Mouse is active.
What about his personality? What if he went a little crazy? What if he talked some smack? What if he went
out of
character?
He's talked some smack. You should see some of his last couple of interviews right after his last fight, before his last couple of fights, when he's like, UFC screwing me. They want me to do this, and I'm going to do this, and I don't want to do this. And I mean, Mighty Mouse is not, he's not a...
I've missed those interviews. I've seen the ones where he's always, everything's great, life is beautiful.
Yeah, I mean, he's put out some interviews where he's talked about how he thinks things aren't fair. He's not getting the promotion that he needs.
He's probably right.
He's absolutely right. I believe he's absolutely right. I don't think that man gets the amount of promotion and backing that he needs. And he is a good ambassador for the sport. You know what I mean? He's scandal-free. He's drug tested.
That doesn't sell.
You know what I mean?
That doesn't sell.
I know, but did you see his last submission?
That was insane.
Did you see how beautiful
that
was?
Yes, he threw him in the air, caught the arm.
That's a thing of
this
art.
Is it Harlem Globetrotter move?
That's a thing that they put in movies. You know what I mean? That's the thing that they call for John Wick 2, and they
and
have the Machado brothers. Yeah. The dude was not, it wasn't, he hasn't had any like
walk. It wasn't a walking
fights.
Dead.
You know what I mean? He wasn't a nobody. The guy has skills, you know what I mean?
But in the bottom line, in this game, in a fighting game, you have to be marketable to make big money, to sell pay-per-views. You cannot be amazingly talented, and have no fan base.
I think you got to bring the technique and the circus.
Okay.
Mighty Mouse doesn't talk shit. He doesn't put on a show outside of the octagon. He comes in and he performs dominantly. And right now, he is the greatest fighter in pretty much when it comes to defenses, title defenses that the UFC has ever had.
I'm going to say the biggest secret in the UFC, because no one knows it. Chael Sonnen talks a lot of shit, doesn't win the big fight. But
he's the circus. He's the circus.
But people love him. People pay attention to him. And he's actually a very nice guy. Oh, wait.
Chael's a great guy.
Very humble.
Chael's a great guy.
He's never turned me down for an interview.
No,
which,
and he won't.
No, but a lot of people sometimes, you know, if not right now, call me back.
Heads get big, or yeah, I get it.
As superstar as he is, it doesn't matter. Last time I saw him, he was walking with his mom. I didn't even know, and he's like, yeah. "Sorry, I'm gonna do this interview." Like he was really cool. Like he,
dude, he's always been that way, and he's always been a hard host.
That's what helps being a superstar,
and that's what helps keep him, you know. I don't want to say relevant, but it helps keep him in the business with people respecting him and wanting him to be around.
So if you had to give Mighty Mouse advice about making himself popular, what would you tell him?
I would tell him he's going to have to bring a little bit of the circus.
What is that? Like go to someone's gym and call him out, or Conor McGregor, drive a Ferrari?
Yeah, he might have to do that. He might have to
floss, go to a strip club.
He might have to, like, you know, get caught for, you know, smacking somebody in public, make TMZ. He might have to, you know, verbally call somebody out, like, you know, talk some shit.
But none of that's gonna happen. So
it's not gonna happen. So
and his
you know what's gonna happen
to the end than the beginning of it.
Yeah, but he's gonna go down the books as one of the greatest.
Maybe appreciate it down the line, not right now.
Yeah, you know, it's unfortunate, but yeah.
So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekpak reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter at Sekpak, and you can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Sekpak.